we resume tonight's post-game press conference with the head coach of the Trinidad and Tobago team, Coach Brad Williams. You know, give us an opening reaction to tonight's 1-0 victory, and then we open the floor to questions. Coach, must be ready to start a one-way
position. Yeah, definitely. I think for this game, I think this is where we want to get away, get rid of that for this game jitters. We definitely know that what we wanted to walk one of our toughest position. So we had we paid a lot more attention, I would say, to our opening game, and we know how tough it had been. But I must say congrats to our team and the way they applied themselves to the strategies as well.
First question for the coach.
Coach, when you talk about the coach, the team seems to have improved in the second half. What about you talk about the coach, sir?
Yes, I thought, not knowing there was much of Guadeloupe, all I know they had four players who played in France, I know that they are Portuguese. We was a little bit hesitant in terms of going forward, which I was going to consider, but when I saw the high portion, we had to play a little more direct. In the second half, so I asked the players the midfielders to think they could push a bit more higher up the field and use a little more direct ball behind the ball of defense because the middle was more pushing on us and personals.
Having said that, in the post, while you mentioned like pushing forward, there seems to be at times gap in the middle of the game.
Yeah, to a certain extent. I must say, you know, the team just come together for the first, well, it's 6 weeks, we go together 2 months now, and our first 2-3 weeks we had to go out of screening. So I know the coincidence of the team in our first game, I know there could be little gaps like that and room for improvement.
And what was the difference in the second half?
Well, like I said before, when I saw them playing, I know they were pressing us. I saw a lot of space behind the ball defense, so I asked my players to play a little higher on the field, and if we could play a little more direct, which means play the ball behind the ball defense.
Finally, what were your thoughts on the standard of the game overall?
Well, I was pretty impressed. You know, pretty impressed. As I said, expectation was high with the quality of Boldon, and I must give compliments to our players. I think they responded well, and they adhere to coaching instructions, especially as you saw in the second half.
Finally for me, these two teams seem to be a little better than the other two teams. Is that your assessment? What are your assessment of the other two teams?
Yeah, generally we can see that. I know I was a little more aware of the Turks and Caicos and Deacon Self, St. Lucia. Yes, these two teams would definitely the toughest team in the group, but again, I would not take any of those teams for granted. And what is important for us, focus, and we need to qualify and finish on top of the group.
Yeah, coach, but there also seems to be some defensive jitters in the course of, are you satisfied with the partnership between this and Sam's number?
Well, I know, yes, the partnership between Mason and Samson definitely have to improve. There definitely was some jitters in the beginning of the game, and I think a little bit of complacency because our team is a team kind of maintain a lot of possession and sometimes we build up the ball from the back. But you guys see, what the team was high pressing, so we had to kind of, as I said, play a little more direct. But Mason and Samson at this point in time, we are two better central defenders, and we have to go back to the training and spend a little more time in cohesiveness and better understanding.
Jabari.
Oh, yes, just like Cramps, and also the junior better icing right now in the ice stop. And he'll be ready for next game coming. Likewise, Jared Dallas too. Little bit of crops, but you don't feel the same way too.
Very much. Alright, coach, thank you very much for your support.
You're welcome.
We're going to return now with Captain Jabari Mitchell and also our journalist.